Chairperson, ministers of government here present, members of parliament, representative of the UN agencies in Sierra Leone, the head of the European Union delegations in Sierra Leone, members of the diplomatic and consular corps, all parliamentarians here present, members of the fourth estate, survivors of sexual gender-based violence, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I'm grateful to be here to make the keynote statement during this policy dialogue aimed at translating our policy and legal commitments to action. Let me thank the Ministry, especially the Honorable Minister and her partners for putting together such an advocacy campaign forum. We have come a long way as a nation to address the prevalence of sexual gender-based violence, but our efforts are constantly frustrated by perpetrators of sexual gender-based violence who do not have anything to provide for the future of our girls and women. We therefore call to action this day and going forward to undertake a renewed commitment to save the lives of our daughters, sisters, nieces, aunties, mothers, and the list goes on. Well, I was just talking to the minister who just informed me that we now have men raping boys in Sierra Leone. I thought that was against religion. But if we have that also, then I believe Sierra Leone, we need prayers. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I'm here this afternoon on threefold to raise my voice on the end of violence against women and girls as campaigner and a mother of Sierra Leone. Second, to join with solidarity all stakeholders charged with the responsibility of providing services for victims of sexual gender-based violence in Sierra Leone. Third, to invite you all to join my campaign in the coming years, and my campaign title, Hands Off Our Girls. Please help me say this, Hands Off Our Girls. And when we talk about Hands Off Our Girls, it's Hands Off Our Girls in every aspect. Hands Off Our Girls, do not marry our girls when they are not ready. Don't pregnate our girls, leave them to go to school. Don't rape our girls, because raping them is killing their destiny. Do not traffic our girls. You don't go to the village and take someone's child, bring them to the city, just for them to be abused while the parents sit in the village thinking that you're sending them to school. So we have to emphasize on this. We have to let this country know together that we're ready to stop these people. Unfortunately, these are hopeless people. They are not supposed to be in society. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the theme for the campaign to end violence against women and girls in 2018 focuses on Orange the World. Hear me too. I think if we don't do something about this now, tomorrow, we are also telling the perpetrators to tell us, shame on us for not acting. And it is time that we take this fight to them. We have to now fight them. I was going through some documentations where the analysis is that Sierra Leone has gone through war, and during the war, they have rape. They have all of this atrocity caused to women. But we don't have war anymore. You can imagine if we don't stop slavery. 400 years ago, our forefathers, great-great fathers, they were all slaves. If slavery was good for us, why did we fight to stop it? The people fought for that so that we would leave as decent people, not as slaves again. We cannot have just few people in our society to hold us ransom just because they cannot control themselves, just because they do not have the decency to do the right thing for our children.
we have to act. The Honorable Minister had left because I wanted to challenge her. She have a passion, she have the commitment to actually make this easy for all of us. Because where we have this stumbling block is at the courthouses. Where we have problem is at the courthouses. And not just the courthouses also. I'm grateful that the representative of the police is here. I think the police, they need to do more. This is not the time for us to say, well, I go and arrest this person and then take them to court. Unfortunately, we bail them. This is the only country where I see they locked up a man just because they steal a goat. But you leave a pedophile on the road.
Thank you.
Just because they went and bailed themselves. Our prisons are full with people that are not supposed to be there. While we have pedophiles roaming our streets. So I would have loved for the minister to be here so that the minister and the police, they can actually commit not just words and signature here, because for us to succeed in this journey, we need the minister, we need the police, and we need the paramount chiefs. We have to empower the paramount chiefs again. We have to make sure the paramount chiefs belong, they feel belonged. Because if you take all these cases and bring them to the city where they're going to leave the people to go free, what's the point? It is only in this country where I see you take a little girl, 5-year-old girl to court, and then you put them in front of the man who raped them and say, tell us your story. Only in Sierra Leone. But guess what they will say, Mrs. Bia, you're not going to keep you, you know, you can talk all. Well, I have to say this, because you know what? I don't want to build all the mansions. What I want is to have a legacy that no other First Lady can change. When we have the right policy, that right policy is not for another First Lady or another President to change. When we have the right legislation in place and it is implemented, not just selectively implemented. I just heard that when a boy was raped by his teacher, I'm not saying it's a good thing, I'm just saying when a boy was raped, the rapist was sent to Padepa straight. How many girls have been raped and the rapists stay out and enjoy their freedom? We cannot be selective in what we do in this country. We have to do the right thing for this country. And this is not the time to say, well, President Bio have to come and do this. President Bio is just one man. It is for me and you and every other person here, including the police. If we have to use the military, we have to shame them. We have to bring them in places like PZ and let the whole country see them. We have to put them on social media. We film them and disgrace them and put them out so that their own children can see what their fathers are good at. If we do all of this, believe with me, if even you think of your own mentality, you will start to ask Jesus Christ to cleanse you. But then when you go to court, you hide the perpetrators at the back and then you bring the victim in public and tell the victim to explain their story. That's stupidness. Because it is the victim that you protect. It is not the man with the money who goes out there to destroy kids. I want to see this thing change, please. I want us to be able to walk in the street and know that our children are safe. I want us to be able to sleep at night when your child said, I'm going out to a party. You're not worried about who is going to be raping them on the road back home. How many of us have the ability or the finances to hire a private security for your child because they want to go out? We have to be able to live in this country freely. So I am so grateful that God has given us a minister whose agenda well before now is this one. And I don't know whether she actually communicated this to Julius Madabio. But I know this is the minister that will go to every courthouse and make sure we have justice if we can get the support of the police and the judiciary. So we are begging you guys. There is no way we will achieve our goals. This is not about us. These are policies that this country needs. We are living in a civilized world, for goodness sake. How can we call ourselves civilized when the statistics is against every woman in this country? What is civilized about our society? When a woman can be battered and nothing will come out of it. When a woman goes to the police station to make a statement, they tell her, go sit down under force. Una step, una get trouble on her house. My husband was supposed to protect me. If my husband battered me, the only place I can go is the police station. So the police, we are not your enemy, we are your friend. And we rely on you for our protection. And we hope that you will not only protect us, because you are police officers. We are hoping that you protect us because you are our brothers, you are our uncles, you are our fathers, and that your duty is to be able to protect us. If we all are emotionally attached to this cause, we will succeed. If we make it a financial campaign, we will not succeed, and we will come back 20 years later, we will still not succeed. I have already declared that my job and my mission is to work on this. I am not going to be Fatima as usual from January 1st. It is not Fatima as usual anymore. When you see us in the street, when you see us protesting, when you see us in courthouses, when you see us in police stations, please join us. Do not just leave us there on our own. The more voices and the louder our voices, they will take us seriously. We cannot just leave the minister to be the one going to courthouses. There's a thing called social media now. When we send that message that courts tomorrow, you should know what we mean. And let us go there. If the police want to fight, we will fight. So please, me, I'm here. I am not even going to be the drama or the English person. Me na Creole baby, correct one. Here at the gate. Lord, we fight this now. When we say hands up, they say, oh, enough is say that one day too strong. What is strong pass when you get a pedophile, the pin you picking down and destroy the entire life and then scot free and walk and just go? Because he knows that if they go free anyway, get money. So no times know the way bad or worse for a pedophile than to tell them you are hopeless and you do not belong in our society anymore. So please, again, I'm saying, on the 14th, this is just like the beginning. Me and the minister, we said, we're going to start off. This is like a campaign, we're going, it's warming up. On the 14th, we will talk to the nation again. And this time, it will not just be me and the minister, but it will be like seven other force ladies around Africa coming to Sierra Leone to help us. So on the 14th, we'll be at the Bitumani. Please come and let this country hear our voice. And the good thing, on the 14th, His Excellency will be there. And he will have to listen to us. And he will have to understand our pain. And you will have to understand why his wife has changed to this person. Because he needs to understand. And I'm so grateful that he supports everything that I do. And I listen to the passion when he talked about rapists. And he said all rapists should go to jail for life. That is a presidential statement. You don't change it. When the president speaks, that's it. That's the word of God. He said, life, don't go and start negotiating anything in those courthouses anymore. And we'll try and get the president to make pronouncements on early marriage, make pronouncements on violence, make pronouncements on everything that has made our country what it is today. So that they will understand. And the good thing is, when Julius Madabio says something, he means every word. The 14th, join us. The 15th, we will parade this country. We will go out. We will go out.